What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 54 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Brilliant Diamond. Last time, we beat the Elite Four, and now it's long last time to fight the Sinnoh League Champion. And we know who, all know who that's going to be. Making sure all my guys are in tip-top shape here before I do anything. Let's see how we are in terms of moves. Everybody got a pretty even spread of how much they were going through. I mean, we've all still got all of her avalanches. I don't know if we're going to be using Roserade all that much, but I got plenty of Dazzling Gleams. Looks like Gyarados is pretty good, as is Crobat, and still got plenty of moves for Garchomp, and yeah, I think we're going to be fine. But now it's time. It's finally time to take on the Sinnoh League Champion. Alright, let's do this. Oh, that theme song. Have you been keeping well? Thank you for Mount Coronet. I'm truly grateful. Together, you and your Pokemon overcame all the challenges you faced, however difficult. It means that you've triumphed over any personal weaknesses, too. The power you learned, I could feel it emanating from you. But that's enough talk. Let's get on with why you're here. As the Pokemon League champion, I accept your challenge. It's time to fight Cynthia, probably the toughest Pokemon League champion in any game of the Pokemon series. And she's got a full team of six. She uses a mix primarily Dragon, though, although she started with Spiritomb, who is Ghost Dark, and up until Gen 6, that type had no weaknesses whatsoever, if you were Ghost Dark. And we're both using Pressure. If I had to bring in, I meant to bring in Roserade to use Dazzling Gleam. Well, let's see what I can do with Night Slash. Alright. So we're gonna use Shadow Ball. That's gonna hurt. Actually, no, it died. Never mind. Okay. Keep using Night Slash. Oh, she's gonna withdraw. Okay. Who are you gonna bring in now? Bring out Lucario. Okay. So you're tempting me to try and switch things up a bit. Okay. I think I know exactly who I'm going to bring in for this one. Let's bring in Infernape, my ace. Alright. Lucario's going to try Aura Sphere. I don't think this is going to do too much damage. I take that back. It took quite a bit. And it's enough to make Infernape use its Citrus Berry. Hopefully I can get a Flamethrower off. I was going to try Aura Sphere again. This is probably going to put me away. Oh man, Infernape toughed it out. 1 HP. That's the love right there. That's the love. And we put Lucario away. That was close. Alright. Who's coming in now? Gastrodon. Well, this would be perfect for Roserade. Alright, Roserade, because it's going up against Water Ground. Giga Drain should put it away. And I'll be ready for Spiritomb when it comes out, if it comes out. Level 60. Now you see why I did so much grinding, because I knew these guys would be really high leveled. Giga Drain. See if we can put this guy away with one shot. Indeed we can. Oof. And who's next? It's Spiritomb. You know what? We'll keep Roserade in. If I can get a Dazzling Gleam off, I'll be in good shape, because this is the one type he's weak to now that fairy types are a thing. Dazzling Gleam. Let's see how you like this. And down goes Spiritomb. Got the critical on top of that. Getting really lucky with those criticals, I'll say that much. Alright, Infernape hits level 66, which I think matches the level of her ace. Now Milotic is coming out. One of the tougher water Pokemon out there, probably the toughest. This is level 63. I'm hoping Giga Train can do a lot of damage. I hope I don't get hit by an Ice Beam. That's what's worrying me. Excuse me, Mirror Coat. Oh, jeez. Perfect way to counter that. Ah. If you use the Flame Orb, interesting move. That will increase your attack, but burn you in the process. Interesting move. Alright then. Well, I think I'm going to fight water with water here. I'm going to bring in Gyarados. Actually, what I'm going to do here, I want to bring Roserade back in, so I'll use Max Revive. Oh, you know Recover. Interesting. But you're still burned. Yeah, Recover is only going to recover your HP, not necessarily heal your burn. So I guess we'll just keep Milotic busy for now. And here comes that Ice Beam. That's the move I'm afraid of. Luckily, Gyarados can take it, even if it is a critical. Milotic is going to be a beast to take down. But by hopefully bringing down its speed a bit with this Bulldoze, this can set up Roserade for a quick KO. I want to get its HP down to somewhat, I guess, like around the yellow level. But you're going to make me really work this one here. I definitely don't want to bring Garchomp in if Milotic is packing an Ice Beam. Let's really work on this guy's speed. Where's that Ice Beam again? Ah, Gyarados is frozen. Okay. I'm going to take a gamble here and bring in Roserade. Hopefully he'll use Recover instead. Now use Ice Beam. That's going to put away Roserade probably. Now I had enough left in the tank, and speed loss is significant enough. Probably get one Giga Drain off. Another Ice Beam that's gonna probably put Roserade away. Hanging on. Taking advantage of that burn. I think one more Giga Drain could put it away, unless she uses a full restore, which is exactly what she did. Okay, well, it's time to recover a bit. And that burn is gone now. Probably get one more off, which should recover enough HP for me to survive one more Ice Beam. I'll have that Flame Orb kicking back in. Hopefully the burn will put it away. Here comes Ice Beam. We avoided the Ice Beam. This is our opening. And actually, the burn is going to put Milotic away. Whew, that was a fight. Roserade, Crobat, both level up. And Gyarados, I think, is still frozen. Next up is Roserade. I think I'll let Crobat do this one. Let's take to the sky. Try and Shadow Ball. You're gonna miss. So I'm out of range. We'll fly me enough to take it down in one shot. Yes, excellent. Alright. Alright, Weavile's gonna level up. And she's bringing in her Ace Garchomp. Now I'm gonna leave Crobat in because I wanna do a little bit of healing. I can't remember the last time I was put in a corner like this. Garchomp, Dragon Ground, level 66. A guy I know very well, I've got one on my own. But I'm going to do this. I'm going to go ahead, burn a max potion, bring, actually, full restore on Gyarados. Again, I'm just using Crobat to kind of, Swords Dance coming into play, which is going to really jack up its attack power. I think I better make sure everybody's healed up here. Dragon Claw. That's going to take down Crobat in one shot. Okay, now I'm hoping. Let's see what Gyarados can do with Ice Beam. One of the reasons why I taught it Ice Beam is so it could go up against this guy. Bring down its attack a little bit. Negate that Swords Dance. Ice Beam. Use Dragon Claw. Whew. Gyarados took one mother of a hit, but here comes Ice Beam. He's gonna try and block it with that berry. Oh, wow. Using that Yashi berry. Alright. And Dragon Claw's gonna probably put it away. Alright, now who's quicker, Garchomp or Weavile? Garchomp is at 176, Weavile's at 204. Alright, Weavile, you're up. This is coming down to the wire here. Hopefully I can get an attack in before it hits me with Dragon Claw. I was going to use Earthquake. One hit KO. I think Gyarados is going to be my key to victory here. Max Revive on Gyarados. Again, Infernape is probably just going to take the shot here. I wasn't expecting Infernape to survive that. He was down to 3 HP. But Garchomp is just so quick. Now that it's got that berry out of the way, hopefully Ice Beam can put it away. If not, I may be in big trouble here. It's going to use Swords Dance. It's going to take the time to try and bump his attack up. Now's my chance to strike here. I would have loved to freeze right there. I won't let this end yet. This match is too fun to let it end this easily. One more Ice Beam. Now's doing the full restore there. I would love to get a freeze. Maybe one more Ice Beam could put it away if I can survive a Dragon Claw. Oh jeez, I'm in trouble. I am in deep trouble here. I wonder, what will Dazzling Gleam do? Okay, Roserade toughed it out, so we'll get the Dazzling Gleam off. And how about that? Roserade with the Dazzling Gleam. Oh, he's still got 1 HP left. Oh, no. I thought that was the end. It had 1 HP left. Who's my fastest Pokemon? It's Weavile, but... Alright, I'm going to have to rely on Intimidate then. Fire up Gyarados. I'm just gonna use a full restore here as well. Beam off. We need a freeze. Okay, we avoided the Dragon Claw. If I can take one shot, put him away with an Ice Beam. Here comes Dragon Claw. Good, it survived. Will the Ice Beam put him away? It's gotta do it this turn. I think we got him. Oh boy, what a fight. Garchomp goes down to the Ice Beam. We win it. Gyarados, MVP. Oof, that was a fight. And we have defeated Champion Cynthia. Just a few minutes ago, you were the most powerful challenger. And just now, you become the most powerful of all the trainers. You are now our newest champion. And you didn't make it easy for me, and thank you. That is going to be a good fight to have in the LP. I'm going to tell you that right now. Thought you had me on the ropes there for a while there. That was excellent. Truly an outstanding battle. You gave the support your Pokemon needed to maximize their power, and you guided them with certainty to secure victory. Actually, I wasn't that certain. I thought you had me there. You have both passion and calculating coolness. Together, you and your Pokemon can overcome any challenge that may come your way. Those are the impressions that I got from our battle. I'm glad I got to take part in the crowning of Sinnoh's new champion. Now then, step onto the lift. Yes, ma'am. Going to the Hall of Fame. What, you weren't coming with me? I guess she'll meet me in there. The Hall of Champions. The room ahead is the Hall of Fame. Ah, Professor Rowan. Good for you to show up. T.U.G, your last battle was splendid. Oh, hello, Professor Rowan. A child I enlisted for my Pokedex project has come this far. It's only natural that I come and witness their crowning achievement. T.U.G, I shouldn't call you a child anymore. You've grown into a real champion. Professor, you still enjoy the enthusiasm kids bring to your research, don't you? Step this way, please, T.U.G. Professor Rowan, I need you over here as well. It's been a long time since I last entered this room. If the last time you were here was when I became champion, then yes, that would be quite a long time ago. T.U.G, welcome to the Hall of Fame. Your names will be recorded for posterity here. What you are leaving are the memories of your adventures so far. It's time to record your names, you and your Pokemon. Remember, your Pokemon are partners that grew with you through many challenging battles. This machine will make a permanent record of your achievement. Wow, all I can say is that was one heck of a fight to end this LP. Welcome to the Hall of Fame. Weavile, level 63, my Ice Dark type. Roserade, level 64, my Grass Poison type. Gyarados, level 63, my Water Flying type. Crobat, my Poison Flying type, level 64. Garchomp, level 63, Dragon Ground. And last but not least, my team captain, Infernape, a Fire Fighting, level 66. Team, welcome to the Hall of Fame. You guys did me proud. And this is a nice group photo here. Snap, I think I'll put that on my photo gallery on my Switch. That was one mighty finish. Overall playing time was a little over 33 hours, although I think only 30 of them were recorded. I think I grinded for like a little over 3 hours getting ready for this last battle here, but hey, we did it. It was all worth it in the end. Come think of it, I did just barely enough there. So we've beaten Pokemon Brilliant Diamond, and I'll just go ahead and give my thoughts on this so far. I will say, first of all and foremost, this is not the end of the Let's Play. There's a lot of post-game that we're going to go over. Probably some legendaries, a lot more than this game. Now, my initial thoughts of the game, I was never big into Gen 4 when Diamond and Pearl came out. And actually, I only played Platinum before I played. That was the only game I played on Gen 4. And it was actually the reason I got a DS, because I wanted to play the game. Anyway, the reason why I didn't really like Gen 4 was because I didn't think it really brought that much new to the franchise, aside from a few new Pokemon, several that I used in this LP. But overall, I've kind of gained a new respect for it. The world map and the traveling was a little not as straightforward as some of the other Pokemon games, but this was a nice return to form. And I like the fact that it was kind of like a one-to-one recreation of the Diamond and Pearl series. I did miss the distortion world that Platinum had, and there were a few things in Platinum that I wish were in these games, but I guess they either didn't feel like doing it or didn't want to at the point. But nevertheless, that's just a personal thing of mine. I'm okay with the graphics. I know a lot of people were divided on the chibi style, but ultimately I think it worked, and I personally liked it. Although I definitely preferred Sword and Shield, their graphics over there, and that was just an amazing game. If you haven't played it, Hunter P, I am thinking about you when I'm saying this. Go play it, because it is probably the best Pokemon game out there. I'm not kidding you. I digress, though. I will say this is a fantastically done game. It was well worth the wait. And heck, it even had me bring back the Ultimate Let's Play after retiring it like a year ago. This is probably going to be the very last Ultimate Let's Play I do, because I think I'm going to be doing other projects aside from my Let's Plays. Don't know exactly what's on the agenda next. I do have my 15-year anniversary coming up really soon at the time of this recording, although by the time I have posted this, it'll be long past that. I'm recording this right before the turn of the new year, and my 15-year anniversary is on January 9th, so I'll probably be streaming or doing something before there. But anyways, I think that's all the rambling I'm going to do for this project here. I'll go ahead and let the credits roll. We'll watch this brilliant ending, it looks like. And I'll get back to you once the credits are done, and we'll talk about what we're going to be doing next. So I'll be quiet for a bit, let you watch the credits. Home sweet home. The end. So, like I said before the credits start rolling, this is not the end of the Let's Play. As a matter of fact, I don't know how many more episodes I'm going to be doing because we got a lot of post-game to cover. So many legendaries, and I think a few more places will load up as well. We find ourselves back at home, just trying to see if I can trigger anything to kind of give us a rougher idea of what's going to happen. It's saying go to the first floor, so I'm guessing something's going to happen when I go downstairs here. Hi, Mom. T.U.G, Barry came looking for you a little while ago. I don't know what it was about, but he was shouting about you needing to get on a ship at Snow Point City. You know how impatient he is. He was gone before I could even ask. Anyway, how's it going, kid? Is your project with Professor Rowan coming along? Well, why don't we check in with him and give him a bit of an update on how our Pokedex looks. Let's see. Where is the lab? That's Barry's house. Oh, the lab's all the way in the next town over, so... Why don't we go ahead and head there real quick. And, the ship he mentioned is going to be all the way up in Snow Point City, and that will ultimately be our next destination. I guess there's something going on up there. Where are my repels? I'll just use repel. We're going to be dealing with level 3 Pokemon as I just try and get to the next town. Here we are. Professor, the Pokemon Research Lab. Let's talk to Professor Rowan real quick. Ah, T.U.G, you've come to show me your progress on the Pokedex. Yes. So you've seen 146 Pokemon. You're not far from seeing every Pokemon there is to see in Sinnoh. I don't think there's that many more we have to find here. Let me go through the list real quick. Now, they consider the Pokedex complete if you at least see the Pokemon. You don't necessarily have to catch it. So, who am I missing? I'm missing whoever's between Snorlax and Riolu here. I'm missing three Pokemon here. Probably Azelf, Uxie, and Mesprit. So, and then, obviously, Palkia as well. So, I think there's only five more Pokemon we actually need to see. So, this Pokedex is near completion. I think once we see all 151, I think that's when we get the National X. I'm going to have to do a little bit of research and know for sure. But anyway, Barry said there's something up at Snow Point City. We'll go ahead and head there real quick. We'll have a chat with Barry. Hopefully he doesn't want a battle, because I'm already tired out from this episode. I actually recorded this Pokemon and the previous episode back-to-back. Literally without saving, so, now where is Barry? Oh, Barry, where are you? Hope you didn't drag me here for nothing. Anyway, I'm just gonna go ahead to the Pokemon Center here and, just call it a day here. But apparently there's some ship we can get on here at Snow Point City. Alright, well, we're already healed up, so there's no need to heal again. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and call it quits. And next episode, we'll officially begin the post-game of Pokemon Brilliant Diamond. So until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.